In the famous letter of the Rebbe, Breshchedes Vatov Shir Aleph, the Rebbe writes about the preparations that should be made before Yud Shvat. And the same applies before Gimel Tammuz. And the Rebbe writes, as we shall explain to people, about the tremendous Avas Yisroel that the Rebbe has to each and every single Yid, and to go places where the youth meet and tell them about the Chibur Yaseira, the extra measure of love that the Rebbe has, and the expectations of them is tremendous, and he has full faith that they'll be able to accomplish what has to be done. By the Rebbe, we see this tremendous Avas Yisroel that is completely dedicated and given over to the people, to call Yisroel. And he's giving his most precious possession. He gives his time to each and every single Yid. We find by Moshe Rabbeinu, before Matan Torah, it says, Vayered Moshe min ahor, that Moshe Rabbeinu came down from the mountain. So Rashi says, Melamed, it teaches us, Moshe peina lasokov. Moshe didn't go to take care of his needs that he has to take care of. El min ahor, el ha'om. From the mountain, with Hashem, he went straight to the people. You can imagine what the asokov of Moshe were, the needs of Moshe were, was Torah mitzvahs anyway. But nevertheless, he gave priority, el ha'om, with the people. What we see by the Rebbe, there's no parallel in the annals of history, how much time a manig Yisrael, a godlo Yisrael, gave away for klal Yisrael, for each and every single Yid. And it was available for everybody, for men, women, children, people who keep mitzvahs, people who don't keep mitzvahs. For example, the Fabrengens. In the previous generations, the Rabbeim used to Fabreng only a few times a year. Many months they were not even in Lubavitch. They would travel for whatever reason. It's going to Saklal for the Fuhr. They were not even available there. For example, the famous letter of Yutus Kislev, Zoshana Lechsidus, the Rebbe Rashab wrote because he said he wouldn't be able to be in Lubavitch and Yutus Kislev. So he gave them a letter. That letter, was, by the way, was written to for Samach Beis right before the Rebbe was born. So by the Friedrich Rebbe, for example, in America, only Elter Chassidim were invited to come in to the Fabrengens. There were Bochrim 770 who never saw the Rebbe, the Friedrich Rebbe. Some of them saw, they were able to give him a minute. They were lucky to get a minute to go by the Friedrich Rebbe and say L'chaim, and that was it. But otherwise, people didn't go in. When we were kids, before Bar Mitzvah, they just built then the new shul. It was called Over the Shalash. So it was in the middle of the construction of just finishing the building. And they had the roof on already. So we used to go to the Fabrengen, stay with the Fabrengen. And we were kids. So for the Maimer, we took a break for a few minutes. We went out. So we went out from the steps next to the Rebbe's room, going to the second floor, midway up. There's a window. Now they have an air conditioner there. In that window, you're able to get onto the roof of 770. And at that time, they had skylights in 770. There was no air conditioning, so the skylights were open just to get some fresh air. And we looked down by the Fabrengen and so on. Then, after a few minutes, we jumped out of the window and coming down to the steps and going back to the Fabrengen. As we're jumping out the window onto the steps, we see Rebbe Tzachaya Mushke walking up the steps. And she asks us, Milostach nishta rein zum Fabrengen? They don't let you into the Fabrengen. She knows in her father's time, the Friedrich Rebbe's times, people didn't go into Fabrengens, let alone kids, didn't go into Fabrengen. So here, we heard this, by the way, we ran away. There was no answer to give. We just machta vayivrach, and we ran away. But the concept is that by the Rebbe, the Fabrengens were open to each and every single Yid. Kel dichfin, everybody who wants to come to the Fabrengen. The Rebbe had Fabrengas, 1,907 Fabrengas the Rebbe gave us. 11,000 hours, 1,558 memorim. Hundreds and hundreds of sikhs that the Rebbe said in the weekdays, and even on Shabbos and Yontif, not by Fabrengen, from the bima where the Rebbe stood. And so much time was given for Yalde Yisroel, for Idish Kinderlach, by rallies, by parades. The Rebbe spent hours and hours with the children. Those are the most precious moments. The Sheib Neis Chabad for the women. The Rebbe said at Sicha every single year before Shavuos by the convention, and every single year by the a special Sicha before Rosh Hashanah. The Rebbe said Sichas for the girls who are graduating high school and going, counselors going to camp. The same thing with the Skenim, for the elders in Keil Levi Yitzchok, the children of the Wednesday hour that made a special Fabringim for them, and Chalamei Tzukis, Mitzion Yitzahal, the soldiers who came to see the Rebbe. All because of Avas Yisroel. This was the Rebbe's Avas Yisroel and care for each and every single Yid. In addition to that, after the Fabringens, the Rebbe spent many, many hours, countless hours in Migmagia to look over the Sichas, to edit them. They should be ready for print, should be available for Klal Yisroel. And this started out before Shavuos Tovshin Yudches. Rabbi Leibel Raskin and a few other Bochrim, Rabbi Leibel Laskin later became a shliach in Morocco, as everybody knows. So they gave in a sicha to the Rebbe before Shavuos Tovshin Yudches, that the Rebbe should look it over, they should be able to publish it, and so people should have what the chazed in the shuls on Shavuos when they go to Borough Park and other neighborhoods. The Rebbe gave out the sicha. It was poshet a simcha. Till that time, there was hardly any sicha that the Rebbe was magia. The Rebbe's Pasha Magia, a Sikha, when Pasha was dancing, a Sikha from the Rebbe came out Muge. No, so they got that Sikha Muge. So they decided the next Shabbos they can begin a Sikha also. They go Chazen the Shuls every single Shabbos, not in the Taluche, not a whole parade, but they go to many, many Shuls. So they gave in a Sikha to check over. Rebbe Chadakov calls in Rebbe Leibel Raskin and asks him, did you give in a Sikha to the Rebbe to check over? He says, yes. He says, what did you do? Do you know how many letters are laying on the Rebbe's table? In Yonah Pikuach Nefesh, life and death matters. People are asking questions. There's letters and letters and letters. And you're giving in a sicha the Rebbe should check over. So Rebbe Leibel Raskin didn't lose himself. And he tells Rebbe Chadakov, by us to have a sicha from the Rebbe, this is our Pikuach Nefesh. This saves our lives. Rebbe Chadakov didn't answer. The end was, the Rebbe was Magia the Sicha that Shabbos. They gave it the next Shabbos again, and next Shabbos again. And every single week for an entire year of Tovshin Yud Ches, from Shavuos till Tovshin Yud Tes Shavuos, the Rebbe was Magia Sichas. And that's what Chelik Aleph and Beis, those Sichas were made at that time. And in the later years, it continued different cycles when the Lukut HaSichas came out, and the Rebbe put in a tremendous, tremendous amount of time in the Sichas. The Rebbe said, Pasha gekocht in them. Simchas Teira, Tov Shin Lamed Beis, there's a whole issue about the Lukut HaSichas coming out, they should stop the publication for whatever reason. So the Rebbe said, Ich hab geharibet in them. I toiled in Lukut HaSichas. No one has to explain to me how precious Lukut HaSichas is. I worked on the Sichas, I worked on the Maram Ekemis, I learned it through the Rebbe's Mitchila Vatzei from beginning to end. But all the Maram Ekemis, after it's printed, in addition to what I read it before it's printed, I learned it after it's printed. The Rebbe once said that to check over one paragraph of one Sicha, it took him 5 hours. When you read the Sicha, you don't even know what went on over there. 5 hours for one paragraph. The Shabbos that Sabbat Tosh Chav Zayin, they asked the Rebbe, they want to know which Rashi the Rebbe is going to speak about so they're able to review it and look it over and prepare themselves. So the Rebbe said, but if I bring in Erev Shabbos, I myself didn't know. That means the Rebbe worked on it a whole Friday night. The Rebbe once even said, but if I bring in clearly, it was Sabbat Tosh Chav Hei, the Rebbe said, he asked a number of questions on the Rashi, and then the Rebbe said, well, Singanigen, people meanwhile can look over the Rashi, and maybe they can think of an answer, of a teretz. Because ich hab dem gehorbet a ganze Nacht. I worked on this a whole night. The Rebbe was, Lamamish lived in the Sichas. And the Rebbe was always very, very upset when people didn't ask questions on the Sichas, weren't involved, weren't make a pilpul. I can tell you about the Diava Uvde, with me personally. I was involved when I was a bocher in 770. So the weekday sichas, I was involved in giving it out and preparing it for publication. And there's anocha built in muge. But at that time, the sichas usually came out days later, sometimes weeks later. So I decided one time we have to make a sicha that should come out on time. So this was Chof Hei Iyar Tovshin Lamed, and the Rebbe, as mentioned before, spoke a sicha with a convention from the Sheikh Chabad. So I decided this sicha, we'll try to make it quick. The whole sicha takes a half an hour. We'll prepare it right away. We'll make it 1, 2, 3. So what did we do? I set up 2 tape recorders in those days. No, there's no digital recorders like we have today. 2 tape recorders are running in a room, like a hookup in a room in the building next door to 770. And as soon as the Rebbe spoke 5-10 minutes, there was a bocher that was able to type it right off the tape and put it onto a sheet. I looked it over, added Mar Mekemis, made the paragraphs, the sentences, the sagnin, checked everything over. And meanwhile, they switched the tape to the next tape and they're able to type the next page and so on and so forth. And while this was going on, I was able to prepare page by page by page while the Rebbe was talking. We didn't have to wait till the end of the sicha. And as soon as the Rebbe finished speaking, right away, the first pages that the Rebbe spoke were already ready to be put on stencils. Those who know what stencils are, to be put on a mimeograph machine and so on. After the sicha, ladies just took over to the Rebbe to ask a brocha. So that took about another hour. So in that hour and 15 minutes, we're able to actually finish off typing the entire sicha, putting on a mimeograph machine, running it off on both sides, stapling it and so on. When the Rebbe came up from downstairs to go back to his room, the maskir gave to the Rebbe the sicha, the ready-made sicha that was already finished and stapled, to given straight to the Rebbe. So the Rebbe says, "Von hein bei Nacht? It's from tonight." Couldn't believe it. It never happened before, never after. Hein bei Nacht? No. The Rebbe left 770 that night after midnight. When the Rebbe came back the next morning, the Siche, the Rebbe brought it back, full of Ksaviat Kedish. The Rebbe's Magia, the Siche, added many, many details. It was a dover beit. There was something there. The Rebbe kocht sich in the sicha, and it happened to be a long sicha. That sicha was over an hour it took. It sprinted in Lekut HaSicha, Chelik Ches. Because by the Rebbe, the koch, the chayis was the sichas, the fabrengens. Why? Because this is something that's negeya each and every single yid. In the maimer, the end of the maimer of Bosi Legani, Tovshin Lamed, that the Rebbe said, Yishvat HaGodl, by day. Those 2 fabrengens, by day and at night. So unfortunately, the day Maimed is not published in Teres Menachem for whatever reason, because Maimed came out Muge, and they incorporated some parts of the Maimed into the Mugedike Maimed, but this Maimed is not published. So the Rebbe said, Gvaldike Asius in that Maimed. Gvaldike things. The Rebbe said that in order to bring about the coming of Mashiach, we reveal the Eitzra Elyon, the treasures from above. What is that? That's a fortzes to spread pnimius ha-teira chutzo, to spread the essence of teira, which is chsidis, to spread it all over. And the Rebbe used the expression, we take the mayonis, we take the wellsprings, umen gist, means we're pouring and pouring and pouring. The Rebbe is talking about himself, that maybe one drop will go in to the ben ha-melech, to the prince, and call Yisrael b'nei melachim heim. All the Yidden are considered to be princes. So this, the Rebbe spent the time and energy. Why? To help out every single Yid. Maybe one drop will get in and will revive him. Tov Shin Lamed Ches. After the Rebbe received a heart attack, a tremendous, terrible, very strong heart attack, and the doctor says that he has to have full rests from Meshach's man, from long time, for many, many weeks. So right after, the Rebbe asked, he wants to speak to Chassidim. So the doctor said, okay, a few minutes will allow you, we'll give you a microphone, you can speak a few minutes. The Rebbe spoke about a half an hour. A sikh and a maimer, I remember the srakshus, the tremendous emotions that took place in the 70 that we couldn't expect, that the Rebbe is going to say, it was unbelievable. But the Rebbe spoke to Chassidim with Mesiras Nefesh. Not only that, later he was Magia, it was a Maimer, it was a Sikha, and this went on the whole time. The Rebbe spoke the next week from his room. And it was even more difficult in a way, because by Fabrengen, the Rebbe used to speak a half an hour, 35 minutes, 40 minutes, and it was a nigun. Here, the Rebbe spoke constant. The Rebbe spoke from the room. There's nobody there to sing the gunim. So the Rebbe kept on speaking. And the Rebbe spoke Napshi Yotze Bedabri. For example, Pashas Lech Lecho, the Rebbe spoke about the Shtochim, about not giving back any parts of Eretz Yisrael, etc., etc. And the Rebbe was Magia di Sichas. The Rebbe gave out the Sichas, even though it was against what the doctors expected him to do. But he said, this is what brings me refuah. For example, right after, also, the Rebbe asked for the mail. Right after the Chastel, the Rebbe wanted to have the mail. So the doctor says, you're not allowed to read any mail. You're not supposed to read the mail. People are writing you all kinds of questions and things that they have bothering them and troubling them and reports that are not so pleasant, etc., etc. So the Rebbe said, if you're worried about my health, if I know there's a letter there that someone writes to me, then figures that I can help him, and you're not letting me help him, this, on the contrary, will impact my health in the negative way. And Avos Yisrael, which is unprecedented, unbelievable. The Rebbe was spread chassidus. The Rebbe published maimorim and sforim, as we mentioned before, that were never published before, for the Alter Rebbe, the Mittel Rebbe, Tzemach Tzedek, everything that was available was published. Even though that we know later on that the Rebbe said there was a kitrug, similar to what happened with the Alter Rebbe, that the Bezno Shlomayla up above of spreading chassidus. And this was the whole parsha of the Sforim that led up to Hei Tevis. And the Rebbe put himself on the line, so to speak. When came the time to print the Ayin Beis, the famous Hemshech of Tofrish Ayin Beis, the Rebbe said he's afraid to print it. For whatever reason, we don't understand these yonim, but the Rebbe printed it anyway. Why? Because of the Avas Yisrael to each and every single Yid. Yechidus. In the earlier years, till Tavshin Chofei, the Rebbe had Yechidus 3 times a week. Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. 3 times a week there was Yechidus. Afterwards, it was 2 times a week after Tavshin Chofei, until it stopped completely. And everybody went into Yechidus, said that when they came into Yechidus, by the Rebbe, there was nothing else. The only thing on the topic, on the agenda, was the person's concerns. The Rebbe was involved completely. They never met anything like this in their lives. I remember when I went to 770, Seder Chassidus started at 7:30. I would come to Seder Chassidus many times. The Rebbe was still there from the night before, from Yechidus that started at 8 o'clock. People came in, not everybody came in with Psudas Tevis. People came with all kinds of problems, and this problem, that problem. If we see, for example, the letters, every day the postman used to bring in sacks of letters to the Rebbe. And the Rebbe once wrote to somebody, it's a bochadek in Australia, that asked a question to the Rebbe, and he said he doesn't want anybody to read it. So the Rebbe wrote them clearly, all the mail is opened by me personally. They say that people wanted to buy the Rebbe like a letter opener, an automatic one. So the Rebbe said, if someone maybe closed, sealed the letter with a tear, I should give it over to a machine to open. We see today the Igros Kodesh that are printed. This is not all the letters. There's many letters that couldn't be printed. That there's tshuvas, minus, tzetlach that are printed lately in the tshuvas that are printed on Ashir, Mamish. Thousands and thousands and thousands of letters on every single topic to every single person, adults, children, men, women, religious, not religious, people in the public offices, and so on and so forth. But it's Yisrael putting everything together to reach each and every single yid. No one has to mention about the dollars. The dollars, everybody knows, was mamish, that you can go and speak to the Nosi Hador. Anybody, without an invitation, without an appointment, whoever wants, kel dich fin, kel dich tzrich, come over, get a dollar. People ask the question, that I've answered them. And we all know about the miracles that were pushed rolling in the Sunday dollars. Just what we know is just a drop in the bucket. The Rebbe gave his time and energy. The Rebbe stood on his feet. The Rebbe suffered from his feet. People don't know, but the Rebbe's shoes, the back of his shoe was pushed down. It shouldn't squeeze on the foot itself. The Rebbe suffered. He wasn't allowed to stand for so many hours. And the Rebbe stood. Why? Because of the Avas Yisrael to each and every single Yid min Nahor Elohim. The Rebbe writes the Losh Chiba Yaseira. What's Chiba Yaseira? So in Pirkei Avos it says, Chaviv in Yisrael, the Yidna beloved, they were called Banim Lamokim, for example. But that's a Chiba Yaseira, Nedas Lohem, that they were informed that this is happening. And the Rambam explains, when you inform somebody, that shows an extra measure of love, that's a Chiba Yaseira. It says, when you give him a ton, it's Sorech Leidi, you have to Mediya. So the Rebbe was Mediya, what each and every single Yid has, the treasures that they have. He gave them onashir, as the Fabrengen, when we were chosen to go to Australia, Tovshuch of Zion, so by the Fabrengen, Tetzabach of Zion, the Rebbe said, Be'ato hakri be'lecho, that Meisha Rabbeinu brings people close to him, and he gives his strength, his keches, his power to each and every single Yid. Meisha Ben already finished the Mishkan, and he already brought down B'shachanti B'seichem, that each and every single Yid, B'techol Echad B'yechad, that every single Yid has the Mishkan within them. But what we demand, the Rebbe said, don't do something new by the Yid. Just reveal the Mishkan that's already prepared by the Nasi Hador, by Meisha Rabbeinu, already prepared the Mishkan. Just reveal it. And even this, you're not doing it with your own keiches. You're doing it with the keich of Meisha Rabbeinu. For sure you'll be matzliach, you'll be successful, no question. The Rebbe said, amazing lashenis, a sprintle kutasichas and the chelik vov, but not everything is there. The Rebbe says, you learn the chatmimim, you learn the chatmimim, do epes, do something. Of them at the gehod of it, the chatmimim, that's why you are raised the chatmimim, to do all kinds of other things. Do what you have to do. Sending the maim avata to Tzave, we all know, what the Rebbe gave out, the last maim the Rebbe gave out, minyorei emuna, the Rebbe gives us the emuna, the Rebbe feeds us the faith, the Rebbe gives, but the Rebbe tells us about this. And that's what the Rebbe said in the famous Sikh of Chof Ches Nissen, Tovshin and Aleph. Ich gib das Iber zu euch. What does it mean? Because the Rebbe gave us all the keiches. But now we have to do it ourselves. The Rebbe gave us Fabrengas and Sikhas and Maimorim and Yechidas and Letters and Minus and Setlach and Dalas and Lekah and Keishol Broche for each and every single Yid. How much more? How much? Nobody ever gave so much. Never, ever in history did it happen. But now we have to do it, Aveda Shalonu. Our own Aveda, Aveda Atzmei. And that the Rebbe said by that Sikhe, the Rebbe said that even when we scream at Mosai, when people scream at Mosai, it's only done b'pnei Atzivui, because they were commanded to do it. It's not that they're screaming, they're told to do it, they scream. At Mosai, the Rebbe said, do mechav mutan emes, and really mean it. For sure, Mashiach would have come. Like the Rebbe once told somebody, he gave me a shokeach that he grew a beard. Man who didn't have a beard, a shokeach for the beard. And then the Rebbe told him, I specifically did not tell you to grow a beard because then it would be my beard. I want it to be your beard. You're doing because I told you. And that's Chiba Yaseira. Chiba Yaseira is the Rebbe told us that we have the keiches. The Rambam says, and that Mishnah, Chiba Yaseira, that when you mediah, you tell somebody, that shows an extra measure of love. And now that we have to use it out. And the Rebbe's Avos Yisrael was in every single detail. And the Rebbe Poshet couldn't take when somebody said Chas V'Sholem a bad word about Yidden. We know in Tovshin and Aleph, the Rosh Yeshiva in Bnei Brak, who said things, inappropriate things about Yidden, the Rebbe spoke very, very sharply. I saw Rebbe Tevis and Pashva Yechi. The Rebbe says, Hepech HaEmes, Hepech Kovish LaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Hepech of the honor of the Yidden. And the Rebbe explained it at length. It's a classic Sikha that every single Yid in the world should learn. It's printed in Sefer HaSichas Tovshin and Aleph. An amazing, amazing Sikha just to shows Mamish the Avas Yisrael that is Pashit, living within the Rebbe to each and every single Yid. And the Maimer Bosit Lagani, Tovshin Lamed, that I mentioned before, the Rebbe said amazing words also. The Rebbe said that in order to be successful and to be victorious in the Melchome, the Melech Atzmei, the Melech himself, puts his life into danger. And he uses all the treasures, his treasures that he has, and the treasures that his forefathers and had before him. And it's given over to who? It's given over to the soldiers in order they should be able to be victorious and win the Muhammad. But the Anshei Chayil, the soldiers have to know that the Melech is with them, the king is with them. And this itself, knowing that the king is with them, this gives them an extra measure of keyach, of strength and power. They should be able to be menatzeach, they're able to be victorious in this Muhammad. So about the Rebbe, whatever I'm saying is just general things, because those who want, is there's many, many books printed already to know and to care, and my story, and one by one, and like to borrow the phrase of the Rambam, call us asforim aleim edavaze, it's full all over with sipurim, and constantly be a new sipurim of the Rebbe. So ashreinu matev chalkeinu, that we have the tremendous, tremendous chus, but we also have the tremendous achrayis, as the Rebbe said many times, the responsibility that the Rebbe showered us, and mamish gave us avas Yisrael, ad bli dai. So now we have to do what the Rebbe expects of us, to utilize it, to use it out. So with the nisken zanzach mit nerebn do lamato, vuhu yigoleinu, tekef, umiyad, mamish,